We use all the biodynamic preparations. We use it in quite a unique way. We use it firstly in the conventional way of preparing them, stirring them, like I told you the story of the vortex and of the cyclists and that whole visual, and really stirring them up. There are various ways of stirring them. Firstly in a bucket, so on a small scale doing it in a bucket. There's another way of flow forms. I'm using flow forms to actually recreate nature. If you think about water and things that flow, water never runs in a straight line. It always twirls and eddies and so on and so forth. And that's actually energizing. It's creating those vortexes. Now there are various flow forms out there that recreate that and basically do the stirring for you. The little picture on there is basically one taking a flow form and showing how the actual eddies and the energizing and so on works. So that's flowing. And basically what your flow forms, your stirring does is really energizing your preparation. So you've made the preparations firstly from your cosmic influences and from your energy influences on there, as well as the actual materials that you're using. So those materials influence what role they play in the natural system, but your cosmic influences also come into. And then you're stirring it and energizing it before you apply it. Now we apply the conventional way, which is stirring, and then spraying it out there. You can either spray it or you can use it in your irrigation system, but the main one is actually spraying out. Now we do it on a secondary way as well, which is using a thing called a field broadcaster. Now a field broadcaster is a way of bringing modern science into biodynamics. The field broadcaster was invented by a guy called Hugh Lavelle in the States, probably about, I think, 15, 20 years ago. And in effect, what it is it's a pipe with two wells and two transistors, one of them going into the soil. And what I mean by a well is basically a glass jar with a coil around it which picks up those energies, and basically it's like a radio, you're transmitting those energies out. So you've got a well that's going into the soil and you've got a well in the air that's going up into the atmosphere. Obviously some of your preparations work in the soil, some of your preparations work above as well. And these, basically, if you have this preparation, you have your field broadcaster. If you don't put anything in there, it's like not switching on the radio. So what we do is we put the preparations in there, plus a couple of other things. I mean, there are things like various kelps and various nutrients. Whatever you put in there, it's going to actually transmit. And you need to be careful about what you put in there and also what you put around it, because it picks up those energies and transmits them. If you're suddenly putting herbicide and killing everything off around it, you're going to be transmitting that herbicide's energies and signal out there as well, which is obviously not what we want. So that's the field broadcaster in essence.
What sort of range are you talking about?
Well, the beauty of the field broadcaster is that it in effect, it makes the practicality of doing biodynamics much more accessible. So you can do, I speak under correction, but you can do, I think it's up to about 600 hectares with one field broadcaster. And how it works, and I'll go into a bit more detail about it. How it works is, and where you put it, I've told you how it works, but where you put it, now that comes back into energies, and energies we find all around us. I told you the story about energies and the hair on the back of your neck rising when you walk into a room. That's the energies you're picking up on. Now energies we find everywhere. Your cosmic energies come out a bit like a ray of light, hits the earth, reflects and goes along until it hits something up and it goes up again. And they're called ley lines, those lines. Now those lines are everywhere around it. It's not actually something special as such. Obviously it's special if we utilize it, but it's everywhere. Now, where you put the field broadcaster is basically on a power spot. What's a power spot? Sorry, I'm going to have to go into a bit more detail to understand. A power spot is a place where you have a whole lot of different ley lines connected. Once you've got a power spot, two or more, but usually the stronger the power spot, the more the ley lines are connected. As soon as you have the connecting ley lines, you have a power spot, and the power spot, how you find it, is basically like the old Chinese, the yin and yang, the black and white, the positive and negative energies, and you actually douse it. So how do we find the energy ley lines? Firstly by dowsing, and then also by asking when you douse where the ley lines are.
So just start.
I'll show you.
Okay.
So the ley line dowsing is basically picking up energy. To go into that, the dowsing, you can douse for anything. The most common in this day and age, the most common thing that we know about dowsing is the old people used to find water with it. So when you teach yourself how to douse, you actually you start with finding water. As basic as putting a hose pipe down where you know it is, and you douse and you actually find the hose pipe. And then you go, you do various exercises and teach yourself how to do it. But everything has energies, and you're picking up the energies from you and I, from plants, from the environment, etc. Now, if you're finding a ley line, you basically ask, and you the instrument. You use different. Let me show you. You use different things. Some people douse with a pendulum, so you can douse anything. And you basically just you twirl it and you ask certain questions. I prefer to use what we call L rods, which are basically an indicator. This is all that it is an indicator. And what's actually dowsing is me, and I'm the person who's dowsing. It's a higher being or a higher energy that you're trying to pick up. Now, obviously, with this day and age, as I mentioned earlier as well, this day and age we divorce ourselves from it. And dowsing is a way to get me in contact and convince yourself about it and pick it up. And dowsing, I prefer to do it with all right. So basically, you go along and you teach yourself how to douse. And when you're looking for energy ley lines, you basically ask the higher being whatever you believe in. If you believe in God, then it's God. If you believe in the natural resources, it doesn't matter. It's what you believe in. I'm not trying to say that you should be a Christian. It's got nothing to do with that. It's about what you're asking the higher power out there, be it the energies or whatever it is, permission to douse firstly, and then you go along and you say, okay, I want to open up my L rods when I find a ley line. And you'll go and you douse and you walk, it might be right here, it might be a little bit further, and your L rods will actually open up. And then to find a power spot, you go with one and you say, okay, where's the nearest power spot? Where's the nearest intersecting ley line? And it will go along, you know where the line is now. So you'll go along and it will point towards which way it is. And then you walk that line and you say, okay, where is the intersecting ley line? So you find that spot and you find it, and then you, if it's a ley line, if it's a power spot, you've got the positive and negative concentric spirals going up it. And you actually dial those spirals and you ask once again to open your rods when you find a positive coil or ley line. And close, cross when you find a negative one. And if it's a power spot, you can stand 20, 30 meters away from it and go. And as you come closer, it will open, and then it will come light again. And then when you cross the negative one, it will close. And as you get closer, it happens more and more often, obviously, because it's concentric, it spirals out of it. And that's a power spot. And we take this field broadcaster, and we're plugging it into the power spot, and thereby plugging into the network of energies around us. And then we're transmitting the various energies that we want to transmit, the various signals that we're wanting to get out there, such as obviously the biodynamics. That's where the biodynamic preparation is coming, because those are the synergies that we're making use of in the system. Just to take a step back, if you haven't got the micro life, if you haven't got the broad spectrum nutrition, the biodynamics is not going to do a hell of a lot. You need to have the broad spectrum of nutrition. You have to have the pantry filled up and stocked up. And then you have to have the natural life living there, the microorganisms, the cover crops, the natural predators. And then all of it plugs together and synergizes together with the biodynamic.